What's up YouTube and welcome back to my channel. If you saw this title, then you know what this video is all about. But I have a couple questions for you. How many of you have allowed this pandemic, aka Miss Rona, to disrupt all of your fitness goals? And missing, sometimes consistent, sometimes not, but this week I zoned in and I was able to get it done. I lost 10 pounds and that started from Monday to today. And today is Saturday. So today I'm gonna show you exactly what I did to lose 10 pounds in 1 week.
It's time to boss up. Fix your credit, girl, get at it, get your bag up. Hit that gym and get back fine. Go get that degree, go girl, focus on me. Unlock potential that you didn't know you had in you. Fuck that nigga, hey. Oh, yeah.
So, the first thing you need to do is weigh. And child. Okay, so now that you know where you are, you gotta figure out where you wanna go. So you need to write out your plan. And for me, it always starts with writing out my goals. Here, I am writing out my affirmations for the week. An example of my affirmations are, I am focused on achieving my goals this week. I am committed to my meal plan. I am committed to completing 5 workouts this week. I am committed to work towards my goals even when I do not see results. Okay, if you are like me and you love water but you need a little then you might want to add some lemons and lime to your water. Now, lemon and lime is always my go-to. I feel like it helps me to lose excess water weight, so I always add them. And you know, you might need some containers so you can remember what lemons and limes are. Okay, so here I am cutting up my strawberries from last week. Sometimes you have strawberries that you don't use, and instead of them going bad, I always cut them up and freeze them so that I can use them in my smoothies. So any strawberries that are not bad from the previous week, I cut them up and I put them in a Ziploc bag, stick them in the freezer, and I use them always for my smoothies. And this bag goes in the freezer and I'm ready. These are my strawberries for this week, okay? And I just kind of rinse them off and I put them in the bag just so they're not in that nasty container from the grocery store. There it is. Okay, so here I am rinsing off my spring mix from the grocery store. It says that it's already rinsed, but I don't really trust them, so I rinse it off myself. I am placing it in 5 containers for my 5 salads for my work week. I like to prepare the base of my salads like so. So it's ready to go. And then I place it in the refrigerator exactly like this. So all I have to do in the morning is just prepare my salad. Now this is a little keto bowl that I got from a YouTuber. And here's the recipe here. Basically, it's kind of like a pudding mix. And it's like a crunchy fix, you know, if you like crunchy. But I put all the ingredients together and then I put it in the refrigerator exactly like this. Here are the toppings that I place on top of what you just seen, and I'll show you how it all comes together. Now, this is my post-workout smoothie. I usually do about 4 cups of spinach, an avocado, some almond milk, sorry that it's blurry, and a scoop of Vega Sport protein. Blend it all together and voila. Here's the recipe. Please screenshot that. Here is my favorite salad. Now, I prepare it in the morning so that it's pretty fresh when I get it, when I start eating it at work. Here's my favorite dressing. It's only one carb for 2 tablespoons, and yes, I measure. Here are the lemons and limes that I cut up Sunday night. And here is my water. That's a 32-ounce mason jar. I have about 4 of those in my workday. That's a gallon, or a little over a gallon. Okay, so here is my little keto bowl that I made the other night. As you can see, it has like a pudding consistency. Here are the toppings that I placed over it. It gives me that crunch, the sweetness, the vibe that I need. It is everything. Now, for workout, my choice is always gonna be HIIT. I love the intensity of HIIT cardio. There's nothing that compares to it. And I love this workout. This is the workout that I did when I initially lost all of the weight that I did when I first started my fitness journey. That is Taryn walking around giving orders as usual, but it's a variety. And because I kind of sort of suffer with ADHD, I need this type of workout to keep me focused and to keep my body changing, okay? He just kind of comes up with these workouts, and it is what it is. We get it in, and I absolutely adore it. I mean, he is just an amazing trainer, and it's just a variety. I absolutely love it. Here I am chewing my gum, baby, and just doing my thing, and I'm gonna do it. 676 calories for that workout. I'll take it. Here I am getting it in after class, because we gotta go the extra mile. Weigh-in time. It's been a week, and guess what? Down 10 pounds.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you really take something from it. You don't have to do keto. You don't have to. Look, whenever I get a vibe, honey, I'm like, I hope you can take something from this video. You don't have to do keto. You can do low carb. You can do vegan. You can do pescatarian. You can do whatever your heart desires. The only thing that I want you to do is be consistent in whatever you select to try to achieve your fitness goals, okay? Kids and mates and whatever, but figure out where you are, decide where you want to go, and go after it, okay? Now, this is something that I always do to get myself focused, but we have to understand that fitness is not a sprint. It is for real a marathon. I have to get strict. I have to see some immediate results for me to stay focused on what I need to do and what I want for my body. What I want for my body, what I've been wanting for my body for years. It's been years, honey. I'm never gonna quit. I'm gonna keep at it. I don't care how long it takes for me to keep trying, but I'm gonna keep trying. I might fall off tomorrow, but guess what? By Monday or Wednesday, I'm gonna try again, okay? And another thing that I wanted to say is you have to figure out where your weakness is. Like, if you usually fall off on the weekends, then don't start on a Monday. Start on a Friday. Because when we start our diets and fitness regimen, we hit the ground running with effort, okay? So wherever your weak point is, if it's the weekends, then start on a Friday. And then that way, you're gonna be your strongest on your weakest days. Something that they have to have, okay? So if it's alcohol, then limit yourself to one day a week. If it's you just crazy about food, you don't wanna eat, then give yourself one day. Not that. There's a one meal that you can have whatever it is that you want. even if you just give yourself 30 minutes. And when I used to do this, I promise you, like, I will go to the grocery store, I will pick up Oreos, I will pick up cereal, I will go get Mexican, and I will give myself 30 to 45 minutes to pig out. Like, I was sick, but I had those 45 minutes, I would go buck wild crazy, but when those 45 minutes was over, I was back. You know, you have, okay, well, I'm gonna do a low carb, and then, you know, next thing you know, you got a doggone potato from Jason's Deli, y'all. Or, you know, you can't say you want to be keto and then, you know, I'm saying, baby, figure out what you gonna do, do it, and stick to it, okay? That's all I'm trying to say. Oh my God, I tickled myself. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a big thumbs up. And if you are like me, and your thighs are as big as your dreams, then as long as you're dreaming, you're gonna keep on believing. And that's all you gotta do. I sincerely hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys again on my next video. Bye! What?